Sticking with our theme, Boker Tov, everybody. Sticking with our daily inyanim, both of halacha and chizuk of tefillah. It's going to be a repeat for some people here. We have a beautiful idea in this week's parasha that explains to us a little bit of the role and the function of tefillah. This is pointed out by Rav Avigdor Miller in his Pirush al HaTorah. The pasuk says that we know, of course, the Jewish people were suffering in bondage and slavery in Mitzrayim. And it was getting extremely terrible, very, very difficult, matzav. What was the turning point? HaKadosh Baruch Hu turns to Moshe Rabbeinu and says, I remember that I made a deal, I made a brit with Abraham, Yitzhak, Yaakov. I told him that this would happen, that I would redeem you. If that's the case, we have a hard time understanding the next pasuk. The pasuk says, V'gam ani shamati et na'akat b'nei Yisrael, asher Mitzrayim avidim otam, va'ezkor et beritim. Why was it necessary for the Jewish people to cry out to HaKadosh Baruch Hu? They already had this one in the bank. There was a promise, HaKadosh Baruch Hu said, they're going to be made slaves, and there's time for that happened, and there's time for them to be redeemed. Why was it necessary for them to pray? So Miller points out an extremely fundamental part of tefillah. To explain it, we're going to give an introduction from Reb Chaskel Levenstein, the great mashkiach of Mir and Panovich. He said that people, humans, are different than HaKadosh Baruch Hu. If a human being plans on giving something to somebody, if I plan on listening to you and you ask me for something you request, it might take one or two times, but beyond that, my mind is made up. Either I'm giving it or I'm not giving it. There's no point in continuing to ask. HaKadosh Baruch Hu is not that way. HaKadosh Baruch Hu oftentimes has decided to give a person something. I've already decided, Hashem, to bless you with something. It's just that a person has to pray in order for that bracha to come. The decision is there. HaKadosh Baruch Hu decided to give it to him. It's yours, but it's going to take some tefillot. Why does it take tefillot? Rav Miller explains. Because tefillah is not merely the act of making a request, submitting a form, making a request to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. It's many things, one of which is that a person recognizes his place and is making himself subservient to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. The very fact that I'm asking shows that you are superior and I'm inferior. It shows that I understand my place, that you are the source of all beracha. That is the word baruch, that you are the mekor beracha. That's why the Jewish people had to ask. Yes, HaKadosh Baruch Hu already promised Abraham, Yitzhak, Yaakov that they would be redeemed. It was in the bank. They were going to get redeemed. But in order to bring the bracha down, it requires tefillah. One of the things a person can do to make himself ready to tefillah is always to come early. It ties into the halacha of Hilchot Shabbat. One of the beautiful halachot that we forget about, it's time to bring it back, is that Halacha Maran writes based on the Gemara Masechet Shabbat Kuf Yud Zayin, Yashkim Baboker B'Yom HaShishi La'achen Tzorchei Shabbat. When does Shabbat begin? Not by candlelighting, not by Shkiah. Shabbat begins already when you wake up early, first thing on Friday morning, to start getting ready for Shabbat. Everything that's going to be successful requires preparation. Tefillah to be successful requires preparation. We're going to get that next week, B'zachat Hashem, the halacha of coming early to Minyan.